spirits. And our spirits dwell in the Spirit of the Lord, and His Spirit dwells in us when we accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. So this morning, our future, when we leave this earth, we will be destined for either one of these two places, heaven or hell. Heaven or hell. Today many are saying that there is no hell. And some are saying that there is no heaven. And heaven and hell is right here on earth. That is a lie. But let me put this to you. The Word of God states that there is a literal heaven and a literal hell. Let's look at the destiny of the believer. Because you see, first people can say anything to convince you and draw you close to them. But the Bible states that there is a hell and there is a heaven. Let no one put you in seat of comfort. There is a hell and there is a heaven. There is a life and there is death. And after life, there comes hell or heaven. Philippians 1 verse 23 tells us that when a Christian dies, he departs to be with the Lord. The Lord is not here when you depart with you. He is where he is there to meet you in heaven. He's here right now with us because we talk about his being omnipresent, omnipotent, and all of these nice fine words. But when we die, we will go to a place of rest and to be with the Lord. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 8, Paul said to the Corinthians people to be absent from the body. That means the taking out of the spirit, which is the soul, is to be present with the Lord. This body of mine is not going to be with the Lord. It's going to go back and rot if I'm being put 6 feet under the ground. And even if I am cremated, ashes to ash and dust to dust. So back to the earth we will go. Amen? But to be absent in the body, to be dead, to have a right life with God is to be present with the Lord. But to be absent in the body as an ungodly, you are not going to be with the Lord. You are going to be with the devil and his host. David in Psalm 16 said to the believers, in God's presence, there is fullness of joy. We won't have fullness of joy. We won't have total joy unless we are in his presence. We will have some form of joy, yes. We will enjoy a joyous life, yes. But when we go into the presence of the Lord after death, we will have the fullness of joy. No heartache, no pain, no tears, just fullness of joy. The believer will receive that. But the unbeliever, according to Matthew 25, verse 41 and verse 46, when we reach to the white throne, the judgment seat, those who are not with the Lord, he will say, ye are cursed into, and I'm paraphrasing here, into everlasting fire, prepare for the devil and his angels. It will be sad that if we are at church every Sunday morning, at church every Sunday evening, at church every Bible study, at church every youth meeting, every WOW meeting, every Minna Vision meeting, serve on the ushering team, serve on the friendship team, sing on the choir, play music, preach the word, teach the word, and when the day of reckoning comes, we are going to hear, depart from me, I know you not. Brothers and sisters, this morning we all need to line up. We need to straighten out our life. We need to line up. If the word says, though your sins be as a mustard seed, you can't enter into the kingdom of God. We would be in big trouble if we didn't have Jesus Christ to intercede for us. Because this morning, brothers and sisters, we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God. But thank God that Jesus Christ commended his life for us this morning. That while we are yet sinners, hallelujah, he died for you and me this morning. Had it had not been the man from Mount Calvary, had it not been for the whole rugged cross this morning, all of us would be going down to hell. But Jesus saw that our souls were going down to hell, and he loved us. And we cannot tell why this morning.
Hallelujah.
But I am so glad this morning that Jesus loves me. When we hear of heaven and they say, there's no heaven, I want to tell you this morning. Heaven is a place. Yes? God the Father lives there. And for proof, turn in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 6, verse 9. And mark it for yourself. Have you found it? What does it say? Don't find it yet? Our Father, this is what Jesus prayed. Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Our Father, who art in heaven, that must be a place where God's dwelling place. It's God's dwelling place. And we are expected to go there. It is where his throne is. Psalm 11 verse 4. He sits on a throne because he is the reigning king. And when he shall return, we shall behold him face to face, sitting upon his throne. Amen? So let's not forget this morning that there is a heaven. He has angels. Mark wrote that in Mark 13 verse 32, he speaks about the angels in heaven. John stated that Jesus Christ came from heaven, and I want you to look at that one also. John 6 verse 38, and mark it in your Bible, that Jesus Christ came from heaven. Mark 6 verse 38. John, sorry. Then, when he came to earth after he left heaven, Paul wrote the book of Acts, which is a historical book. It says that in Acts chapter 1, 9 through to 11, that he ascended into heaven. On the day of his ascension, a voice came out from heaven saying, this same Jesus who's taken away from you, hallelujah, he will come again in like manner. And he's now sitting at the right hand of the Father in heaven, making intercession for you and I. What a loving person like Jesus Christ. After he died for us, he didn't say, leave those wicked people down there. I don't business with them because I did have to die and none of them didn't come and bow at my funeral. He continued to say, Father, forgive.